Today I will show you how to terminate Leviton's SDX MTP splice module. To do this, you will need some tools and consumables, including Araben yard scissors, a marking pen, lint-free wipes, isopropyl alcohol or fiber cleaning solution, a disposable bin for fiber shards, and a small screwdriver. When terminating high fiber count, armored, and or outside plant cables, additional tools and consumables may be required, including a flex conduit cutter, a sheath cutter, gel solvent, some marking tape, and a tape measure. A mass fusion splicer is also required during this termination process. The fusion splicing kit should include the splicing unit, a precision cleaver, a thermal stripper for ribbon fiber coating removal, and appropriate fiber holders. The parts that come with the SDX module include the module with lid, and MTP pigtails installed, and an instruction sheet with the marking template for the fibers. The accessory kit includes splice sleeve holders, mesh sleeve used to protect bare ribbon fibers or other jacketed cable assemblies, nylon tie wraps, build-up tape, and splice sleeves. The first step in preparing the module for termination is to remove the top lid. Engage the release tab and lift the lid from the rear of the module base. Now you'll see the pigtails with service coils. You will remove the fibers from the tray and lay them out flat. The splice module has a single chamber which consists of channels that route the inbound trunk cabling, a mounting point for the splice sleeve holders, and a slack storage area where all fibers route to the holder for termination. The pigtails are wound through the storage area, and the pigtail connectors are already installed in the couplers. The pigtails will stay connected to the couplers throughout the termination process. The SDX splice module loads into the receiving slots from the front only. When using SDX fixed enclosures and SDX panels with single adapter openings, route all cables or assembly legs to the front side of the device before beginning the termination process. When using SDX enclosures with sliding trays, remove the tray from the enclosure rearward to perform all termination work. The incoming cable opening at the rear of the splice module has a diameter of 14 millimeters or 0.55 inches. Each incoming fiber should be evaluated to verify correct sizing, as cable constructions do vary. Ribbon fiber should enter each SDX splice module within an outer jacket, breakout kit leg, or other frication tube. The mesh sleeve provided in this accessory kit is not recommended for use with bare ribbon fiber, as the potential for breakage at the point of entry tie-downs exists. Six flat ribbon jacket constructed cables can be routed directly into the module. When using ribbon fiber in a flat frication tube, install a short piece of mesh tubing and the provided build-up tubing onto the fricated ribbon fiber for securing at the tie-down point. Large account trunks or central tubes with greater than 6 12-fiber ribbons or bare ribbon fibers will need to be prepared with breakout kits, frication tubing, or other build-up methods. Follow the manufacturer's directions to prepare such trunk constructions. It is recommended to remove at least 48 inches of outer cable jacket from the entrance point to the splice module. Ribbonized cables should be routed into the module in the following order. Blue represents ribbon 1, orange ribbon 2, and green ribbon 3 in the first splice sleeve holder, and so on through the 6 ribbon groupings in the second splice sleeve holder. Feed incoming cables through the rear opening and secure through the tie wrap slots and over the cable jacket with one of the provided nylon cable ties. This tie wrap will be removed after pre-routing and marking of fibers prior to the termination. Route the trunk fibers concurrently through the cable entry channel and around the module base clockwise. One loop is recommended. Mark the fibers at the zero mark guide, remove the tie wrap, and remove all fibers from the module. As an option, route all fibers through the splice sleeve holder area and cut after exiting 1/2 inch past the far end of the holder. When using this method, you will mark the fiber 30 millimeters back from the end for positioning in the fiber holder. The MTP pigtails are designed to allow splicing to both rollable and flat ribbon, Each splice module is provided with the ANSI TIA 568.3-E Method A polarity arrangement. When providing a Method B channel, one of the modules may need to be mass fusion spliced in a different order. Please refer to the Leviton Applications Note, Polarity Modifications in Splice Modules, for further information. When terminating ribbon fiber, group the ribbons together as they leave the connectors and route the pigtails simultaneously, counterclockwise, through the management tabs until all the slack is stored and the ribbon is entering the splice sleeve holder area. Ensure that the ribbons do not roll or change positions during this step. Mark the fiber at the zero mark guide and remove all fibers from the storage area. As an option, route all fibers through the splice sleeve holder area and cut after exiting 1/2 inch past the far end of the holder. When using this method, you will mark the fiber 30 millimeters back from the end for positioning in the fiber holder. We are now ready to perform fusion splicing. Place the splice module on the right side of the fusion splicer and the bulk cable on the left side. Place the splice sleeve holder near the fusion heater with the target sleeve positions away from the splicer. Install the ribbon splice sleeves to the trunk side fibers. Use the marking guide on the provided instruction sheet to shorten all fibers to 30 millimeters to the zero mark. Load the ribbon into the appropriate fiber holder to the zero mark and strip all tight buffered coating using a multi-fiber thermal stripper. Clean the fibers and perform a precision cleave. Load the cleave fibers into the fusion splicer and repeat for the opposite end. Perform fusion splicing according to the manufacturer's direction, verifying acceptable loss and tension test. Remove the spliced fiber from the holders and position the splice sleeve centered over the splice. Perform the heat shrink of the sleeve. Once each spliced ribbon fiber has cooled, install it in the splice sleeve holder. After each splice, load the ribbon fibers into the splice sleeve holder in the following order. Make sure the internal strengthening device is in the vertical position when you install it into the splice sleeve holder. Now we will begin loading the terminated assembly into the module base. Loosely secure two nylon tie wraps around the incoming cable. Begin by feeding the fibers from the connectors into the pigtail channel. Rotate the module base clockwise while placing the group fibers under the cable management tabs. When the splice sleeve holder is reached, beginning with the first three pigtails, carefully snap the splice sleeve holders into the receiving tabs. Verify all routed fibers are under the tabs and free of all snags. Group the ribbon fibers exiting the sleeve holders and continue rotating clockwise to route the remaining fibers into the module base under the tabs. Ensure that the ribbons do not roll or change position during this step. Cut an appropriate length of buildup tape and place it around the incoming cable jacket. Place the final length of trunk fiber in the channel to the tie wrap entrance. Fine-tune for any bend radius or routing adjustments. Secure the trunk cable to the base with two provided tie wraps. Verify all fibers are underneath the cable management tabs. Install the lid and termination of the splice module is complete. Install each SDX splice module to its target location in a tray, panel, or adapter bracket. If using an SDX enclosure, load each into the final termination location respectively. Attach the trunk to the appropriate tie-down point and route any breakout slack as identified by the device's instructions. If using a breakout kit, attach the trunk breakout head to the first lance point upon entering the enclosure or rear cable manager. Route any breakout slack as identified by the device's instructions. If using an SDX patch panel, load all cassettes into the target panel position. Install the recommended rear cable management tray, secure the trunk, and route all slack on the tray. Learn more about the SDX splice module and the SDX family of fiber solutions at leviton.com/SDX.